Hi guys, my name is Suman Singh Rawat and today we are going to discuss order types. So I think these order types are very important to understand. If you know them correctly, then only you can use them effectively. So I have tried to simplify everything for you. So let's start with the order types. On the right, I have shown you with the help of Kite application, which is from Zerodha. You can see on the right four different types of order types: market order, limit order, SL means stop loss order, SLM means stop loss market order. So generally there are four types of orders: market order, limit order, stop loss order, stop loss market order. So we'll be discussing these four order types, what are the benefits, what are the drawbacks, and what they are all about. Let's start with the market order. The order is placed at market rate, not at the rate of your choice. So if you have a share trading at 10 rupees, you can buy it for 10 rupees, you can sell it for 10 rupees if you place a market order. You cannot buy. The market rate means highest buying rate at that moment, lowest sell rate at that moment. So whenever you try to buy any share, there are different buyers. So whenever you place the market order, you will be placing the highest bid. So if a share is trading at 10 rupees, so you buy it for 10 rupees or 10 rupees 10 paisa 5 paisa. So the rate will be generally either the same or higher. When you try to sell, similarly it will be the lower rate or the current rate. Market order have highest rate of execution except few scenarios. Okay, the market, whenever you place the market order, it must be executed. There could be some odd scenarios. For example, if the stock is in lower circuit, upper circuit, or the trading is halted. What are the benefits and drawbacks, pros and cons? Pros: the order is executed instantly. So you want to get into the stock instantly, place market order. You want to get out of the stock instantly, place market order. You think that the share is moving up and up, you want to get into it very fast, place market order. You want to get out of the stock because it is falling down, you place market order. This is the benefit. And what are the drawbacks, cons? The buy order may buy you at a higher rate, or the sell order may sell you at a lower rate because it is a market order. So whenever you try to buy, you may buy at a higher rate, current rate or higher rate, and whenever you try to sell, you sell at current rate or a bit lower rate. So let's see how does it look like in Kite application of Zerodha. On the left you can see CNC market order, that is cash and carry delivery market order. On the right you can see intraday market order. MKT means market and LMT means limit. So now let's discuss what is limit order. Limit order is placed when you want to buy at a lower price or sell at a higher price. For example, there is a share of Tata Motors trading at 400 rupees. You want to buy it for 395. So you will be placing a limit order, not a market order. And you want to sell it for 410 rupees. So you will be placing a limit order, not a market order. The limit order will be executed if it reaches your price. Okay, this is very correct. You have placed a bid of 395 rupees. If it comes down to 395, your order will be executed. If it doesn't come to 395, your order will not be executed. So if you want to place a limit order, a buy limit order, always bid lower. That means if you want to buy Tata Motors, so place a price lower than 400 rupees. Or if you want to sell it, place a price higher than 400 rupees. Otherwise, if you don't do that, it will be placed as a market order and it will be executed instantly. What are the benefits and drawbacks, pros and cons? Pros: you buy at your own rate, which may be lower than the last traded price. You sell at your own rate, which may be higher than the last traded price. So you can buy cheap, you can sell high. You can buy cheap, you can sell high with the help of limit order. Limit order to set your profit targets. Okay, limit orders are also used to set your targets. You have bought shares at 10 rupees, you want to set a target of 12, you will place limit order. The moment it goes up to 12, your order will be executed. What are the cons, drawbacks? The order is not executed instantly. If you want to execute your order instantly and you are placing a limit order, that may not get executed because limit orders are only get executed when it reaches your price, it comes to your price. So if you want to get into this stock or get out of this stock very fast, you should use market order, not limit. How does it look like in Kite application of Zerodha? You can see MIS means intraday, LIMIT, limit order. Okay, ICICI Bank trading at 342.70, I have placed the same price. So if you want to buy, you can place a lower price of 340, maybe 340, 335, and can wait. The moment it comes down to your price, the order will be executed. Similarly, if you want to sell, so you can bid for a higher price, and similarly it will be executed if it goes up to that price. Stop loss order, okay, very important. Hi guys, if you want to use Zerodha account, you can use the link given in the description box. And what is the benefit of opening the account with us is that we will provide the lifetime support. If you have any questions regarding the use of the application or anything related to the demat account, like change of phone number, change of bank account, etc., so we will provide you the lifelong support. So I have given the link in the description box, so you can click on that, and it is entirely paperless, so you can open the account in 1 or 2 days. You can also personally call me at the number given in the description box.
And third type of order is stop loss order. Many of the people, many of the old traders are not aware of the difference between stop loss and stop loss market. So please make it clear all of your doubts. Stop loss is placed to limit your losses. This is very clear, and this is my personal recommendation. Please always use stop loss. Stop loss limits your losses. If you want to limit your losses to 1,000 rupees, 2,000 rupees, 10,000 rupees, you should always use stop loss. Two prices are set in stop loss order. So whenever you place stop loss, you place two prices, trigger price and limit price. What is trigger price and what is limit price? Limit price is your stop loss price. Trigger price is the moment it touches, listen carefully, the moment it touches the trigger price, limit price order is placed. Limit price order is placed. Because it is a limit order, therefore stop loss can be skipped. Stop loss can be skipped if there is a sudden fall or rise in the script. If there is sudden fall or rise in the script, stop loss can be skipped. How does it look like in Kite application of Zerodha? MIS, stop loss, trigger price and price. ICICI Bank trading at 342.70, 334 is the price stop loss, 335 is the trigger price. The moment it comes down to 335, a limit order of 334 will be placed. Listen carefully. The moment it comes down to 335, limit order of 334 will be placed. So if there is a steep fall, it comes down directly to 330, it will be skipped. Your stop loss order will be skipped. So how can you do, how can you stop your losses? Then how can you place a stop loss which is not skipped, which cannot be skipped? So we'll discuss later. How does it look like in graph stop loss order? I have bought ICICI Bank for 445, target is 495, stop loss is 395, but the trigger price is 399. The moment it comes down to 399, a limit order of 395 will be placed. A limit order of 395 will be placed. Similarly, if you have sold ICICI Bank for 445, your target is 420, your stop loss will be maybe 465, your trigger price 460. The moment it goes up to 460, limit order of 465 will be placed. Now, what are the benefits and what are the drawbacks of stop loss order? Benefits are, it protects your capital from heavy losses, very right. It will protect, always protect your capital, whatever money in total you have. It limits your loss and you can still be in the market. Okay, very important. What happens? You are a beginner. Okay, you are very excited and you are not placing a stop loss. So if you incur very heavy losses, if you incur very heavy losses, you will not come back into the market. You won't dare to come back into the market. So if you are using stop loss, you can still be in the market even after incurring losses, because those losses will not be very high. A buy stop loss order can be used to buy at a higher price expecting a big up movement if it comes, and vice versa. Okay, sometimes what happens, if there is a share price here trading at 10 rupees, okay, now you don't want to buy it at 10 rupees, you want to buy it at 11 rupees because you think that the moment it goes up to 11, then there will be very high up movement of 5 to 10 points maybe. So how can you do that? You cannot do it with the help of limit order, because the moment you place limit order for 11 rupees, it will be instantly executed as market order. So in that case, you place stop loss as your fresh order. You place stop loss order as your fresh buy order. What are the drawbacks? At times, price may hit your stop loss and then reverse back. It happens frequently that you have placed a stop loss of, for example, 8 rupees, share is trading at 10 rupees, it will hit 8 rupees and then come back to 10 rupees. Second thing is that if the market is very volatile, so your stop loss may be hit frequently. Or if you are using a very small stop loss, then also your stop loss may be hit very frequently. Okay, now the last order type is stop loss market order. The stop loss market order is also a stop loss which limit your losses. Okay, just like stop loss, it also limit your losses. Stop loss market has only trigger price. Listen carefully. Stop loss market has only trigger price, whereas stop loss had two prices. So in case of stop loss market, it has only trigger price. The moment trigger price is touched, listen carefully, the moment trigger price is touched, a market order will be placed. So it will not be skipped. A market order will be placed and it will not be skipped. It will be executed. So this is the difference between stop loss and stop loss market, because in stop loss market there is only one price, which is trigger price. The moment trigger price is hit, market order is placed. What are the benefits and drawbacks? Pros: it will not be skipped in most of the scenarios. It will not be skipped because it is a market order. It will not be skipped. Cons: the executed rate may be a bit lower when you try to sell and maybe a bit higher when you try to buy it. Because it is a market order, so it could be high when you try to buy it, or it could be a bit lower when you try to sell it. Also, see how does it look like in Kite application of Zerodha intraday SLM stop loss market. ICICI Bank trading at 342.70, 335 is the stop loss. The moment it comes down to 335, market order will be placed. For example, you have sold the share for 445.25, target 420, stop loss 460, trigger price 460. So the moment it goes up to 460, the moment it touches 460, market order will be placed. So it may be executed at 461, 460, 462, 465 or 470. So guys, this was all about order types. Really like it, please like, share and also subscribe my channel, because I will try to simplify all the complex topics, all the complex scenarios to you, and I'll be coming up with more videos. Thank you very much. Jai Hind, Jai Bharat.